Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Exchange Church Belfast for Grace for Today. It is wonderful to have you with us this week, as we're kind of right in the teeth of summer now, aren't we? And, you know, probably thinking about getting some rest and some time off during the summer and relaxing a little bit. And I just think summer is a brilliant time just to, you know, gather your thoughts and think about, you know, like a new year in terms of church and everything else and schools and getting back September. So I really pray over the summer that you start to, you know, just have this time to enjoy receiving every morning on Grace for Today. You know, we're not going to stop because we believe that every day I don't know about you, I need to know every day about the Lord's goodness, the Lord's love, the Lord's favor in my life and build my life around that. So that's what we're going to keep doing through summer. It's going to look a bit different. We're going to keep you posted. But this week, I just really pray that you'll be so encouraged every morning. And of course, like this, share this, get it out, because we want to see the world transformed by grace. And today I want to talk about how the Lord is always thinking about you. This is great. You know, it says in the Word, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you," says the Lord, "thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." Those are really famous verses from Jeremiah 29:11. But you know, the question I want to ask you this morning is, how do you feel when you know that someone is thinking about you? Remember, you know, in the old days when you used to like get letters and something or a card through the post, that rarely happens today, does it? But remember those days when you used to think, flip, somebody's really thinking about me. That's lovely, because we're in a world that seems increasingly busy. And there, you know, most people are, you know, probably more than ever struggling to kind of juggle all the demands that we face just in everyday life. And quite often, I know I am, I'm going to be honest, I'm always really surprised when people take the time to encourage us, whether it is a card, whether it's an email, a text or a message or something like that, particularly when it's out of the blue and you're not expecting it. You know, for many of us, we're living life at such a fast pace that we take little time to think about ourselves or even like the direction that our lives are heading. If we're not careful, actually, we'll find ourselves so occupied with what's really urgent, the things that pop up every day, that we don't often take the time to dwell on what's really important, and particularly important to us, or what has the Lord sent us. We just kind of get our heads down and get through. It can feel a wee bit at times like you're stuck on a hamster wheel that just keeps turning, just keeps going. And it can almost feel like a luxury to be able to press pause and to consider, like, you know, bigger questions, I guess, or what am I doing? Why am I doing this? Where am I going? And when we do get a minute to take time to think about and to dream about what could be, we're unfortunately often confronted by our own shortcomings and our own limitations. And you know, I've seen it in my own life so many times. We all too easily allow mistakes from the past or fear of failure quash any thoughts that we might have of believing that life can be different from what we're currently experiencing and living in. But you know, today, I think you should take great comfort, and I will too, in the fact that the Lord is not short of time to think about where your life is going. He's not short of dreams for you. What's more, he doesn't discount you because of your failing this morning. If you're inadequate in any way or you're insecure, he doesn't discount you because of any of those things. Do you know, the Lord only thinks good thoughts concerning you. That's it. Take a moment to let that sink in at the start of your week. It's hard for us to truly imagine what such unconditional love can look like. Even with the people that we love the most, we can all at times disappoint each other and let one another down. That's just life. Then we can find our thoughts towards each other becoming maybe negative as we focus on what people are like in the flesh. But you know, the Lord operates from an entirely different grid. The Lord looks at you through the lens of Jesus and his finished work. Now we understand, don't we, at the cross, Jesus paid for every mistake and every failing on our part. What we really, though, need to get our heads around is the fact that when the Lord looks at you today, when he sees you, what he sees is the beauty and the perfection of Jesus. He sees Jesus being spotless, being blameless, and it's with those same eyes and that same grid, that same lens, that he chooses to see you today in that way. In his perfect love for you, I want you to know, as you start this week, the Lord cherishes you and thinks only good thoughts about you. So today, whatever's going on, you can have hope for your future today, because the God of it all, the one who created this whole place and put you on this earth for a unique purpose, is thinking good thoughts about you only. You know, every one of us is made in the image of God. Each one of us this morning reflects His glory through like our personalities, our giftings, the way He's made us. And that's why you can be confident today, okay? And confident for tomorrow. Because you know what Jeremiah 29:11 does? It assures us that we're not only on the Lord's mind, but what He pictures when He thinks of us is goodness, blessing, favor, and the opportunity to reveal His glory in us and through us. It's so good to know, isn't it, that the Lord has had His heart set on us and set on you this morning for such a long time. No matter how you may feel, if you've strayed, if you've, you know, kind of done your own thing, gone off the path that the Lord had for you, remember today that He's the God of new beginnings. At the start of this week, He's the God of restoration. He restores in your life the years that the locusts have eaten, and He is the Lord that has placed His living hope right on the inside of you today. So Father, we want to say thank You for that truth today. What a brilliant way to start the week, isn't it? To go this week, the Lord's only thinking good things for me. He's thinking good things towards me. And His plans for me are good. Whatever's going on, the Lord's plans for me are good, because I'm blessed and I'm favored. I love to think like that. It gives me hope in these days. It definitely gives me hope in these days. So I pray it gives you hope too. And Father, we take this bread this morning and we say, Father, thank You for this opportunity to take communion. Lord, it's Your gift to us. It's not a ritual. It's not something we just do because we do it. It's actually Your gift. And right in this moment, in faith, we eat and we believe that Your body broken for us was for our wholeness, our health, and our completeness. And so we eat today, Lord, and we say thank You, Jesus, for health in our bodies. And Father, we take the cup this morning and we say thank You, Jesus, for Your blood poured out. It makes us completely acceptable and righteous today. No curse over your life today because of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Have a great start to the week. I hope you're encouraged. Every time you think of the Lord this week, just think He is watching over you. He sees the beauty of Jesus on you, and He's only thinking good thoughts. If you're in Jesus this morning, He's not condemning you, shaming you, making you feel guilty. He's not going to extract the price from you this week. All of that was dealt with by Jesus for you. And when He looks at you, all He sees is goodness and favor. He loves to bless His kids. So have confidence this week that Jesus is for you. Amen. That's grace. Isn't it absolutely brilliant? Thanks for watching today. I hope that's a good start to your week. And remember to tune in tomorrow morning, 7:30, for more grace for today.